the incoming tide, swept a line of empty shells along the crisp sandy beach, on parade like thousands of porcelain trumpeters, perspiring with a film of salty brine. Pockets of shadow I wished to close with the impudence of youth. Hungry mouths, bodies gone, taken without fuss by silent undertakers. Empty caskets waiting to catch the sun as the Earth's orbit keeps the present shadow on the march. I skipped along the beach, happy in the gathering sunlight, laughing in and out of the dreams that hung like cobwebs, strung across the waterfront apartments, shuttered windows ignoring the splendid dawn. I was drawn to the sea's edge, the lull of the waves fastening onto my senses. Kashaya. Old knowledge buried in a disused language, suddenly alive with meaning, the absent lamprey hanging ghost-like above the morning mist. I sat down to rest on a silver log, bulwark to the incoming tide. I perused the sea as though it were a new novel, read the ripples line upon line, translucent, partly, angles determined by the push of an invisible moon. The sea began to reflect a message I understood. Seagull, etched on a small horizon, the waves flowing into my being, through to the stillness of me, the gull feeding in the cool water, mosquito drawing blood, red blemish on a muscled leg, substance to substance, a delicate interchange, no malice. Freedom given, universal suffrage, ego merging into the waves, moving with a tidal force, lunar wind blowing across the void of space, full of an intelligence we do not begin to understand. Then the vision. Shuttered mind open. No reserve. The silent observer watching. So this is the great stage and all that it inherits. See there the tip of the angel's wing. The aboriginal choir. A celestial song known and practiced before the dawn of man. Substance feeding on substance, water wearing down the lava rock, sand and mortar breeding houses along the waterfront. Dreams, gossamer threads of hopes and desires, of electoral rolls, of politicians and resolve worn down by cumbersome bureaucracy. The tragedy of good intention borne out because the leaders and the government ignore the natural law and take upon themselves the right to control our conduct rather than emulate better men who have played that particular game many times before and been lauded not by men, but by the gods.